Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Hello, my name is Mike, and today's show is brought to you by our Amazon page. Please remember to shop at MikeO'MaraShow.com/Amazon. It's quite simply the best way to support this show. If you need it, Amazon has it, and you can get it at MikeO'MaraShow.com/Amazon. Bookmark it, please.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Now, Oscar, I know you did a Tech 411 last night.
Yes, Tech 411.
On the 20. Did you get home in time to watch the Diane Sawyer program?
I did not. I saw her on Nightline, though.
Yeah, because she was interviewing Hillary Clinton.
Big deal. I did see excerpts of that.
Yeah, because Hillary Clinton has a book coming out. Mm. Now, we couldn't book Hillary because she's very busy, but waiting without in our lobby, in our conference room out there, we do have someone willing to discuss the book, and I think he'll be here at any moment. When he's ready. He keeps a very busy schedule. And he has a wonderful sense of humor. Perhaps that's why he's making his wait. I can only imagine that he's waiting in our conference room just
laughing.
Wouldn't
it be the green room?
Well, it's not a green room because it's a conference room.
Well, neither was JFK's.
Yeah, okay. Oh, here he is.
Oh, there you go.
You were having a bit of fun at our expense, weren't you, Mr. President?
I was watching Rob do one of his favorite dances, the twist. Hello, boys. How are you?
Mr. President,
William
thank you.
Jefferson
Clinton.
Hello,
Oscar. How are you?
Joining
How's your
us.
Lovely lady, Shannon? How's
She's
she
great.
Doing?
Thank you.
Is she doing still doing yoga in one?
Yeah, still doing,
wow.
still doing the bare minimum to survive.
Oh,
bare minimum.
I just think, there is not a lady on the internet that makes me want to be more flexible.
Yeah, she's working
that's,
hard.
That is for indeed sure.
It's yeah. amazing not only that you know her career, but also her website.
Well, Yoga in One is one of my go-tos.
Really?
You know, when I'm on the road, I spend an awful lot of time alone in hotel rooms. I'm very happy.
I
very,
was
very
looking
happy
at her web hits. I was wondering who logged on from Botswana.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was me.
Yeah.
Yes, I was at a conference. I was at a conference, and I just said, you know, what's funny, though, if I can speak to Shannon, Shannon Katie's website, Yoga in One.
Sure.
I will tell you this, that quite often I will log in. To watch her and learn and do the techniques myself, and then I will find myself slowly drifting away.
Really? In what way?
And just staring at the television without a care in the world, and I won't do any yoga, and by the time I know it, the session's completely over.
You know, sometimes I forget how old Bill Clinton is because
that.
He just talked about his computer by staring at the television.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Well, Rob, I have to ask you this.
Yeah,
in your total quest for dissecting the minutia of the bit, isn't a television screen and a computer monitor, aren't they really one and the same when you think about
well,
it?
I suppose they are,
Mr. These
President.
Days.
Yes.
I will tell you that I was looking at my laptop.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because in Botswana, the hotels don't have very good, TV service.
No,
really?
No. They still got the boob tubes, the bubble TVs.
The boob tubes. That's
yes.
funny. Yeah, I used to refer to the boob tubes as something else.
Yeah, I understand.
Back in my days in Little Rock, Arkansas, there, as a matter of fact, there was a local establishment called the Boob Tube we used to go down to. Yes,
what
I
was
ate
it?
My lunch of chicken fried steak down there.
It was sort of a gentleman's hangout?
Well, you know, men could go and be men, if you know what I mean.
Now
that's
you
what
have,
they could do.
You have managed to keep a lot of weight off. A lot of people say you look too skinny. I think you look great, Mr. President. Are you doing
Thank
yoga?
You. Thank you. I do yoga. I run as often as I can. I try to watch when I'm eating. Of course, as you know, my time during the White House, I was quite well known for not really practicing dietary restrictions like I do now. And now what I take into my body and also what I put out of my body is very, very closely regulated.
I understand. By the missus?
I mean. Well, I don't see much of her, but I am joining you today because it's a big day for Hillary.
Yeah,
a huge day for Hillary. Yeah, she's got the book out. Yeah. I know you wanted me to talk about
that. We want you to hear your thoughts on it and some insight because, you know, this is really the next step to what a lot of people think is inevitable, the announcement that she's going to run for president.
Mm-hmm.
Let me say this about this. I just want to be real honest with you. And tell you that I'm sure her book is going to be a bestseller.
Sure.
I'm sure that she's going to do very well with it. But I, unfortunately, am a little bit behind the eight ball today because I have found myself knee-deep in a more significant piece of literature that is also new this week.
Really?
That?
Now, that's amazing that you would say that because this really, Hillary's book will sort of dictate the future of America. What book do you think compares
to it? I disagree. I think there's a much more important tome. that has been written. And, well, let me give you the author's name. I think every American owes it to themselves. Let me tell you something.
Right.
Every American should get this book, and they should read it. And I'm going to go so far as to say they should read it before they read Hillary's book.
Wow.
As a matter of fact, I would be more than happy to see Americans buy Hillary's book and this book simultaneously. Let me tell you what it is. It's an author. His name is Mike Kelly.
Right.
Good Irishman. Fine Irishman.
Right.
And the book is entitled, well, my God, it's rather one of those involved modern titles. Hold on
just a
second.
Make sure you get it right.
Let me see if I've got it right here. Open Mic. From corporate, from corporate radio to new media, the story of the Mike O'Mara Show.
Now, have you read the book?
I've read the book several times. It's very brief.
Do you have
it? Yes, I read it. As a matter of fact, I read it in the bathroom this morning and in the bathroom last night.
It's content rich. Did you get it on Kindle or did you get it in paperback?
I got it in both.
Really?
You know,
when
it first came out, I read the reviews, and I was so pleased that I wanted to get it as soon as I possibly could. So I read the Kindle version, and, of course, I saw the cover art, and I wanted to have it as a keepsake and put it up on my mantle in my Manhattan offices. And let me say
it's on your mantle?
Yes. If you dive into this book, Kathy, Mike's sister.
Oh, yeah, she's interviewed in the front of it.
She's a spitfire, isn't she? She is a true firecracker. How she tortured that young man.
A lot of people interviewed for the book, including radio executives.
Yes.
But the thing that shocks
me is talking, of course, about Steve Bridges.
Yes.
Marvelous, marvelous executive.
Ever had the pleasure?
Oh, indeed. Yeah, well, where do you think the caucuses are? Where do you
Iowa.
Think
That's
every
right.
modern nah. presidential candidate starts his journey? In Iowa.
That's right.
Yes,
but
Iowa,
considering
yes.
all the people that were interviewed, dozens of people interviewed for this book, what draws you to Mike's sister, Kathy?
Well, it's her candor. I think that's exactly her candor. I'm kidding, of course. I can read candor. You know, her candor is really infectious. I find her narrative to be truly something special, and the way she describes young Mike and how soft and pansified he was is something that really endears her to me and makes me like the book. Yes,
Mr.
Oscar.
President, I caught a little bit of that as well, but what was remarkable to me was the way that she nurtured and tortured at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that is. Therein lies the dichotomy. That is true. And, of course, many of our great leaders do the same thing. You know, there's the yin and the yang, the good
sure.
and the bad, the happy and the sad. And all these things rolled into that schizophrenic bipolar package that is Mike O'Mara.
Now, you still employ a staff, right, even though you're no longer president?
I do, yes. I have a rather elaborate staff.
Did you have the staff research and find you photographs of Kathy?
Oh, I didn't need to do that.
Why not?
You're assuming. Let me tell you something.
Oh, he's serious.
You're making an assumption.
He's pointing.
You're making an assumption that I am not computer literate. And I don't know whether you're doing the age thing,
no.
but I will tell you that I am extremely well-versed in the ways of modern technology, so I was able to do a Google image search on Mike's sister, Kathy, and boy, oh boy, I tell you, I'm just lucky I'm not getting on a plane and flying to Boston today.
Did you find yourself drifting off again as you looked at
I
pictures
sure
of her?
Did. Yeah, to a certain extent, but not drifting off nearly as much as I do when I watch Yoga in One.
Oh.
And by the way, is the website still up and running?
Yeah, yogainone.com.
So when I'm giving these gratuitous plugs with the book and with Shannon's website, we're accomplishing two birds with one
you
stone.
You are. Very
correct?
Kind of you. Appreciate
exactly.
it.
That's wonderful.
I'll make sure
yes.
that she listens.
I tell you, I love that website. I truly do. Yes,
what do you love about it?
I was going to say, what do you like better, the website or the book? Because you seem you like both, huh?
Well, but now you get two questions at once that I'll answer the one. I think I'd really rather deal with the yoga website. It's peace, serenity.
Oh, God.
The female form.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And of course, a general peace of mind and well-being that I get from looking at that. And then, of course, when I read Open Mic, the story of the Mike O'Mara Show from corporate radio to new media. I can't talk about any peace or serenity, but I can tell you that I have an incredible fecal urgency.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
I'll tell you what I know. I know that, in fact, too many kids that begin with pot end up with heroin, then on to LSD. I know that if you drink, you suffer a loss of judgment, if you drink to excess. But I also know that judgment returns when you sober up. I know, and so do you, when you flip out on an acid trip, you never know when you're going to slip out again. This is now, Bentley, not a couple of years ago. We've had time now to see and study the effects of LSD. People who haven't had a dose in weeks sail out on another trip. They never know when. The minute they drop one acid capsule or ingest it in any way, they bought the farm. They've lost any chance to depend on and even restore that most precious of all inner senses, judgment. And to my way of thinking, without judgment, you might as well be dead. Your brain is, so why not the rest of you?
We were talking about marijuana.
We still are. Marijuana is the flame. Heroin is the fuse. LSD is the bomb. So don't you try to equate liquor with marijuana, mister. Not with me. You may sell that jazz to another pothead, but not to somebody who spends most of their time holding some sick kid's head while he vomits and retches sitting on a curbstone at 4 o'clock in the morning. And when his knees get enough starch back in him so he can stand up and empty his pockets, you can bet he'll turn out a stick or two of marijuana. And you can double your money. He'll be holding a sugar cube or a cap or two. So don't you con me with your mind expansion slop. I deal with kids every day. I try to clean up the mess that people like you make out of them. I'm the expert here.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mike O'Mara, Rob Spiewak, Oscar Santana. And now, from his easy chair, here's Mike.
I just gave Rob a sign that says he needs to collect these. I'm curious, Rob, if you're talking about going back and looking at all the old dragnets.
Yeah.
I'm very curious if how many of the episodes would he do that kind of speech? It wasn't every one, right?
No, no. Well, you see, what you need to do is remember, Dragnet started on the radio, then it had the black and white run. The one right. We need to focus on is the color, Harry Morgan, Dragnet 68. And that's when they would bring in characters. Like, do you remember the classic episode with Blue Boy? The young man.
Is that the porno magazine?
No. And do you still take that?
Yes, I do. Yes, a regular in my mailbox.
But Blue Boy was he was another drug enthusiast, and he painted his skin blue. And the entire episode was talking about the dangers of narcotics. I'll do a little YouTube digging today and see what I can find from Sergeant Jack Webb.
It would really be. Here's what I envision. I envision us actually in the middle of every show, if somebody acts out, somebody says something incorrect, somebody makes a mistake, as we do almost every day, that, Joe Friday gives us a little lecture.
Well, what I was thinking, we could even take it to the next level. Mike, I know today we are blessed enough to be sold out, but on days that we're not, we could have a PSA.
We are live from the Cappy Viper Studios and heard worldwide. This is the Mike O'Mara Show. We are powered by Encore Insurance Services with over 24 million downloads. We are heard daily at MikeO'MaraShow.com and exclusively over the air on the mighty 1630 KCJJ in the heart of the heartland. Go Hawks!
Mike, today I have a game prepared for you. It's called Guess the Gender. I'm going to give you a name, and you're going to guess the gender of the TMOS KCJJ Listener of the Day. Are you ready?
Okay. Yes.
Terry Larson.
Ooh. Now you're confusing me. I'm going to say a guy.
Oh, I'm sorry. Buzz yourself.
Oh, no.
It's a lady. It's a T-E-E. It's a T-E-R-R-I, Terry. And we're sorry that we mistook you for a young man, Terry. But congratulations on being Listener of the Day.
It's a lady. The Mike O'Mara Show is a daily podcast and radio show with the greatest listeners in the planet or on the planet. In the planet, they'd all be hobbits.
Yeah, or dead.
Why?
Why?
Because they get it. Today's show is brought to you by Sleep Number Beds. Mm. You know, they called James Bond 007. Well, you should call me 85.
Yes.
Or you should call Carla 85 because her sleep number is an 85. Mine is 0075.
Mm. Oh, da-da-da-da.
But I did tweak it all the way up to 100 last week when my little backy was flaring a little bit. Mm-hmm. But anyway, you can set any sleep setting that you want. That's why, as Carla mentioned to me, it's like having 100 beds each. If you combine the dual air technology, that's 200 beds.
That's
like buying 200 beds. That's what it's like. 200 beds because you could set it anywhere you want. That's the way it goes. Hey.
It's a transformer of beds.
Think of how big your house would have to be.
Oh, my God. There'd be you have to. George Clooney in Lake Como would not be able to do that. I love my sleep number bed. It uses air support and cushions your entire body. It's proven to relieve pain and improve sleep quality. And now introducing, drum roll please, Sleep IQ Technology.
Woo!
That's right.
Nice.
Sleep IQ technology provides a simple and intuitive way to know better sleep, and it's only available on Sleep Number beds. The Sleep Number bed is the only bed that lets you track and optimize your sleep with Sleep IQ technology. An easy-to-use interactive app on your iPhone or desktop. Sensors work directly with the Dual Air technology, and I shouldn't say iPhone because it's any phone that
does
that. Yes,
of course.
Thank you. It couldn't be easier to use. Nothing to wear, nothing to turn on. All you have to do is sleep, my friends. My Sleep Number setting is a 75, as I mentioned before. Carla's is an 85. Remember, folks, only one place in the world to find the Sleep Number bed with Sleep IQ technology, and that is a Sleep Number store. Find your Sleep Number setting today at any of the 450 Sleep Number stores nationwide. You can find one near you by calling 800-511-0061. That number again is 800-511-0061. No better sleep. And don't forget to tell them that Mike O'Mara sent you.
Yes, scream it from the mountaintop.
So welcome. How are you boys doing today?
We are great.
Seems a little mellow in the studio today.
Everybody all right? It's a gloomy Monday.
As our friend Chuck Bell at Channel 4, Mike, he described the weather in D.C. today as soupy. It's soupy out there. Yeah, it's humid, it's hot, and it's there's going to be rain this afternoon. So it's got that sort of mungy D.C. feel that you're glad that you left behind.
It started raining when I walked in.
Oh, did it really?
Yeah.
With the rain cloud over your head.
You have kind of the same conditions we have now. Down here in South Florida.
It looks really sunny where you are.
Yeah.
It is really sunny. Like, it's beating down on you, sunny.
It's going to be 90, 91 with about 100% humidity down here. We're in the rainy season, but we haven't gotten a lot of it. We're getting thunderstorms, and it's intense when they come. But now, what are you giggling at?
91 and moist, just like Betty White.
Oh,
baby!
Yeah.
Yeah. All I know is that the dry conditions, which we have had, we haven't had enough rain, is causing, the way I understand it, from certain extermination companies I've talked to, is causing certain insect life to make it inside, and it's driving me nuts because today, after the Truly Nolan guy came, and I think the Truly Nolan logo is a little... little rat or
now
something
you're
like that. It's got ears.
You're saying it like we should know what it is. What is Truly Nolan?
Yeah, we don't have Truly Nolan in this area.
Yeah.
You don't have Truly Nolan exterminators?
No.
Oh, I've had them for years.
Well, yeah, but I think it must be
Manassas?
A Florida thing.
I think they're nationwide.
I've never heard of them here.
Look
on
up Truly Nolan, Washington, D.C., or Truly Nolan, Virginia.
And is it T-R-U-L-Y, like Truly, like Verily?
Yeah.
And it's Nolan, like
did
your old producer.
Do they show up in the vehicle that looks like an actual rodent?
Big rat truck?
Yeah, I've seen that.
Or maybe an ant on the back of the truck. And you've used them here and you use them down there. And how are they treating you down there?
Well, no, I haven't used – I don't think I used them in Virginia. But let me see if they are a nation.
Remember, Mike, you moved.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thanks for the update.
Yeah, their logo is a little mouse. It's a little mouse ears. Yeah. It's almost like the Disney logo.
I've never seen this up here.
See
no.
Turn around. Let me take a picture.
Truly Nolan is a family-owned pest control company with franchises most commonly associated with the yellow mouse car.
Oh, so they do have a mouse car. Meanwhile, their logo looks like something from Epcot.
It has 83 locations in the United States and 100 franchises in 41 countries, Rob.
I got it.
So it's all over the place.
I got it. It says there are franchise opportunities in Washington, D.C. for Truly Nolan.
Oh, okay.
So they don't have one in D.C.
D.C., MD, or VA. They're not here as of this latest article, the one that pops up on
Oscar,
Google.
You got it.
Pony, I know
that.
You've been looking to double dip. I think you should maybe make that phone call, see about getting your own extermination company.
That's a pretty nice car. I'm looking at them right now.
Yeah.
And with Pony's build, he could get in the mouse hole.
Yeah.
And actually yell at the mice.
So I wake up this morning and called them. I mentioned ants last week, and then I found out on yesterday's show, I told you, hey, man, the ants go marching. That's right, everybody. Rain this morning, continuing throughout the afternoon with lots of humidity. Temperatures in the upper 80s in Washington, D.C. Hope you're enjoying your day. Coming up a little bit later, we're going to let you cool off with a trip to Montreal, Canada.
What?
That's coming up right here on the Mike O'Mara Show.
Montreal, really?
Just trying to think of a vacation. You wouldn't be sending somebody to the Caribbean when it's 90 degrees.
Actually, we would because we could get a deal. It would be your destination station.
Now, am I walking on top of that or am I a little delayed?
No,
you
killed it.
You killed it.
All right, then give it to me again. Then I'll try another one.
Okay, here we go.
Right. Good afternoon, everybody. It's the Mike O'Berry Show. Listen, if you have pest problems, let me introduce you to a brand new exterminator. They're Truly Nolan. That's right. They're all over the United States, 83 locations. They're trying to get a foothold in Washington, D.C. So if you'd like to kill bugs for a living, I've got a number for you. It'll change career paths. Yeah, Truly Nolan from Mike O'Mara.
Pony just showed me all of their cars. Mike, yeah, they have a Stretch Mouse Volkswagen.
Yeah, absolutely.
I really think, you know what? The podcast, it's been a good run, but let's pack it up and let's start killing bugs.
Time to be exterminated. All right, give me the Dave Matthews again, okay, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you about my morning. Mike O'Barra Show, bright and early. Got up this morning. Got a chance to chat with the good guys at KCJJ. I'll be telling you about that a little bit later on. Opened up my laptop, sitting on my beautiful recliner, just peaceful, getting ready to do a little show prep. And lo and behold, I thought Truly Nolan had taken care of my problem, but these little bastard ants started walking all over my fingers. Man, that's a tough way to start a morning, baby. Yeah, so I got the computer out and...
Your brand new computer.
The brand new computer, and all of a sudden they're crawling on the computer. Now, I'm in here now, and I have not seen any ant sign whatsoever. I haven't seen any ants at all.
Did they verify that they were ghost ants? Ooh.
They didn't verify dick because the guy came to my house and put his little mouse rat ears out in my lawn, and I never saw the guy, which incidentally, with me... The perfect house call. You know?
Yeah,
If I can have very little human interaction, I'm a very happy person.
Yeah, but you know what? There would be only one thing to make it better is if he had done something to help you. All he did was show up, charge you, leave, and you still have vermin crawling all over your computer.
Mike, would you say that the ants are haunting you?
Hey, that's great, Oscar. That's terrific.
Yeah. The ghost ants are haunting Mr. O'Mara. The ghost ants are crawling all over his audio and video equipment. Things are not right. No, it's just, I will say that, you know, I know you're joking, but the fact is, yes, they are, in that I feel as though at any time something may be crawling on me. And you know what that's like?
Who are you going to call?
Ant Buster. Yes. Yeah. But, you know, in the words of Dave Matthews, Rob,
are we back to that?
Oh, yeah. I will tell you, you know, everybody hates bugs. I do, too. And right now, for those of you that might live in a rat trap, a bug-infested crack house, I've got something special for you. That's right. It's a year of free exterminations. That's right. All the vermin that's fit to kill coming up for you on the Mike O'Mara Show on WABA.
Your extermination station.
Your extermination station. Your extermination station. That's fantastic. So I don't know. I'm going to assume because they're not here in the studio now.
Right.
I am in control right now, fellows, here, now. Yes. It's an old joke, Oscar. You weren't even a child for that. But that's when Reagan was shot, and Alexander Haig came out and gave a press conference, and they said, who's in charge now? He said, I am in control now, gentlemen. And the fact was, as far as the line of succession, he was like skipping a few.
Well, yeah, he was Secretary of State, right?
He was Secretary of State.
He said, all right, I got this.
He skipped the vice president.
Over this, yeah. Sorry, that president's going to die. I'm in charge right now, baby. That's the way that's going to work.
And the Speaker of the House. And right. I think, I guess so. You skipped at least two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I don't know what the deal is. What's your deal here,
Yeah, what's
Wade?
Your deal?
But the ants were, like, on me out in the other room where I'd never seen them before.
You transported them.
And they were coming. I'm a carrier.
Patient zero.
So they're coming out of the computer. My question is, I wonder if they're in the computer.
No, the computer is hermetically sealed.
Yes, though.
You don't even have a disk drive in that computer.
Again, remember, we have a problem with this old computer in the numbers, the numlock. What if a little ant crawled under there?
Maybe, you know what? Why are you so negative? What if they got the ant to crawl in the old computer and fix it? Do you have a tiny, tiny screwdriver? Just a little guy.
Anyway, when Truly Nolan took care of my computer with their little mouse, and they made it dead, so it was the dead mouse. The only number they worked on was 5.
Dead Mouse 5.
Yes. Sorry, that's the Dead Mouse thing. So I'll let you know. I'm going to give it a couple of days because they have come out here and they have put whatever they do in the ground. It's pretty sophisticated stuff.
What about
you? Would think. Yes, go ahead.
Do you have traps that you put inside?
No, like they don't put any traps inside. Nope, this is all outside because that's where they're hanging out, and they're coming in for a visit, and then they're going back outside.
You know, when
again.
You first built your studio down there like 3 years ago, you had ants.
Yes.
Come to think on it. And I think I think you combated them by putting like masking tape on your windowsill or something.
What they do is they like the electronic equipment. And lo and behold, the ghost ants come in here and they're inundating me with the bug light.
Are they only in your studio, though? Have they walked to anywhere else in the room?
This morning, because I went out there and was sitting there in the living room. And, you know, this is not a big place, okay? So we're talking 5 steps from the studio to the living room.
Right.
And then I'd love to create an illusion of greater grandeur, but unfortunately I must tell the truth.
Do you think they came up?
I live in a double wide.
Did they come up on the elevator?
The service elevator.
Exactly, or the dumbwaiter.
Okay, Rob's letting all the secrets out right now. Ladies and gentlemen, hi, this is Mike O'Mara, and I live in an assisted living facility. I'm actually in a nursing home right now, gentlemen, that's why. And the ants were in the neighbors next door.
Well,
the guy, yeah, the same people that go swimming in the pool with the big eggs in
off
it.
Off the corner of your camera, we see your oxygen tank right in back of you.
Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah.
Oh, this right here?
Yeah.
What is that?
That's your oxygen tank, I think.
Wait a minute. No? That's the microphone.
What they do is they pipe extra air in to make him feel more alive.
Oh, there you go.
That drives Oscar nuts when I do
well,
this.
Well, you're on set.
Oh, well, the lamp looks nice.
There's your lamp from 1980.
Yeah, and what is that? Is that a garage door opener? Yeah. What is that?
I love lamp.
Okay. You know, there's not. Then you go over here. You have the door.
Yeah.
Over here. All right. Hey, in the summertime, everybody, how you doing? We got to take a short break. We're gonna come back with lots more fun and more thrills on the Mike O'Mara Show. Hope you're keeping the ants out of your crotch.
What?
I do. That's right. Well, ants. We're talking about ants, Rob.
Sure.
Julie Nolan, our official sponsor of the Mike O'Mara Show. In the summertime, when the weather is we'll be right back. You can stretch right
up. Hello, my name is Julia Spiewak, and my father is named Rob. Every week, he gets together with his friend Katie, and they do a podcast called Cake and Cookies. Please listen to it. I need it to succeed, because as long as he does his stupid show that's about 90 minutes a week, he doesn't ask me to clean my room. He's a jerk. But I like Katie. You will, too. Check it out every Wednesday at MikeO'MaraShow.com. Cake and Cookies. Please to be a part of the More Network.
Way to go, Julia.
Aww. Doesn't she sound like she's 35 years old
Fantastic.
Now?
She's always been ahead of the curve, God. And nothing proves that better than that.
Sweet.
Way to go. Nice job on that promo, Julia. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. This segment brought to you by The Man Great.
Mm.
The Man Greats are selling like hotcakes because everybody wants to get them for dads. They are 100% made in America cast iron grilling grates and a wonderful gift for Father's Day, which is just around the corner. I am so out of it when I consider father. Is it this Sunday or a
yes,
week
it is.
From
this
Sunday?
Sunday?
This Sunday.
It's this coming Sunday. So you're my God, you're running out of time.
Get on it.
Man Greats are revolutionizing the way people grill. Men's Health Magazine, and listen, I don't just buy it for the topless men pictures. I buy it for their articles.
Yes, exactly.
They call Man Greats one of the best grilling accessories that money can buy. And you know what?
What? What,
yes.
Mike?
A little more. I would expect just
yes.
a little more enthusiasm. And you know what?
What?
Man Greats are the perfect gift this Father's Day. Great for dads, grads, or even yourself. Does a dad deserve the best? Damn right he does.
Yeah.
Click on the Man Great banner at MikeO'MaraShow.com for their $19.99 Dad's Day special. And remember, each order comes with a spectacular Man Great.
You know what, Mike? It's funny. I have purchased so many Man Greats that I have actually a couple. I think I have 3 of the brushes.
Ooh.
I use one just for killing ants. I labeled it because I don't want to cross-pollinate. Yeah. But I do.
Thank you.
Run around and I hit the ants.
Oh, and what a texture leaves on your hardwood desk.
That's why that grilling brush is the most popular in the colony. That's the Man Great Grill Enhancement System. Order today at MikeO'MaraShow.com, and you'll have the juiciest, most delicious Father's Day ever, and we thank you in advance
yes.
for that. Okay, well, here we are. I'm very, very excited about the fact that people are aware of the new book, and
yes.
I want to thank everybody who has been buying copies of this book. Now, a serious discussion. This is when
okay.
Oscar hates
okay.
it when I pull the curtain back.
Please.
But I have to here because I'm all over Amazon, and I'm going in the different subcategories. Because to be honest, we are, we have a niche listenership.
Sure.
We have a limited, we have a finite budget. We have a finite promotional deal here. But
what
the fact is,
categories are you going into?
Yeah, explain what you mean by subcategories.
Yes.
Okay. The first thing I look at is the book, and I see the book, and I see
yeah,
that it's
getting. You type in open mic, and
open mic,
yeah,
and you get
yeah,
the information.
Yeah, yes.
Then I go into a listener sends me a screenshot of the fact that we are on a bestseller list.
Hey, that's
nice. And it is, but it is this subcategory that for the life of me, I can't find. Now, yesterday, late in the day, I go back to this because now I'm fascinated.
Sure.
You know me with counting and seeing how we're doing and that, you know, I get positively obsessed with it.
And you're very good at counting. I mean, you put all the numbers in the right order.
Yeah.
You start
right.
at one and you move up. You're very, right. very good at it.
Well, it's ranking.
You're right,
it's
Rob. You're absolutely right.
It's yeah. rankings is what you're looking for.
Looking for the rankings.
Yes. Sure.
And
where do you think we would land? I don't even know where we would land. I don't even
all right,
know.
Go to Amazon right
okay.
now, Oscar.
Okay.
Go to Amazon. And I'm not going to do this because it'll be a more fun exercise
okay.
If I actually
Amazon.
Let us.
Okay.
Now go to books.
Uh-huh. Oh, I can find that. Yeah, no problem. Books.
Now go to bestsellers.
Yes.
All right. I'm
and
there.
Now look, there now, should be a, there should be categories on the left.
Yes.
Do you see biographies and memoirs?
I will continue looking.
Wasn't that an album from Jim Croce?
I'm gonna do it right now. I'm
oh, now it's
right
a race.
Now. All right, here we go.
I've got the summer
it,
reading for kids.
Oh,
I've got popular
oh.
features.
Are you able to connect to the internet? Okay, of course. What else is
textbooks?
There?
No, it's not a textbook. Look for memoir and biography.
Oh, I found it. Found it. You got to go to. It's below the fold. Is what it is.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're really digging deep. Where are we?
No,
hold
but,
on.
You know, biographies right. are fantastic.
Yeah,
it's
but
my favorite.
Hold on. I go to departments. I'm going to departments.
Uh-huh.
I'm here now.
Oh, come on. Are you
I
there?
See Maria Menounos.
Oh, she's hot.
Yeah.
Oh,
I see,
come on, man.
Hard choices. Yeah, hard.
Yeah,
to get
yeah.
Ah.
Is that got another subcategory? Like on Brazzers?
The soloist.
I have a question.
Brazzers,
you know, when I'm really trying to fly through the internet and,
yeah.
and do something internet related, why does my computer just go into this, we're going to make you look
Mike,
older than you really
it's
are.
It's a brand new computer, so I don't know if it's the
Do you have a lot of
so.
Windows open?
Yeah, how many windows do you have open?
Yeah, go to your what
it's
is that
your
called?
Windows.
The thing you click
your browser.
At the no, the there's a thing. It's like your Command Central or something.
Command Center. Or
yeah.
you can control alt delete and just force.
I'm in there.
Quit.
I'm in
okay,
there.
You're back.
Cool.
You're back. You're
all
back.
Right, cool. Here we go.
Yeah,
right,
I'm here, Mike.
Wait. Okay, arts and literature under biography and memoirs.
Oh. Okay, well that makes sense because that would be like the biography of people in show business, like yourself or Ben Vereen.
Okay, arts and literature, I'm here. There are 84,000 books out there.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Okay, I'm here, Mike.
All right, don't go to the first page.
Okay.
But bestsellers in arts and literature, go to the second page.
It's like a second page.
Are there any subcategories?
21 through 40.
21 through 40.
Okay.
21,
right,
and see where we are, baby.
Page. Let's go.
Take
okay,
a look.
Okay, I'm still going, and I, hold on.
It's called
going.
Open Mic,
going.
Oscar.
Yeah, I know.
Mike Kelly.
I got it right away. We're number 22.
Hey!
Are you there?
I'm here.
Now, are there
right,
other subcategories?
Yes.
Under that, like radio or podcasting?
We're between Maya Angelou and Mindy Kaling.
Mm.
Oh, and you know what? That Maya Angelou, that's a false high because she just passed away.
And the weird thing is, though, there are two open mics. We're at number 22 and number 25. Does that mean Kindle and paperback?
That's the way I would stratify it, yeah.
I think that's the way it is.
Does not say which is which.
We're ahead of Adam Carolla, but Adam Carolla is ahead of us in another category. So we're ahead of Robin Roberts. We're ahead of Lee Marvin and Michael Jackson.
Lee Marvin?
Listen,
are we
Oscar, the joke
beating Lee Marvin?
No, the joke is that these are sub categories. But the fact
is,
I
just had to drill down. Like I don't even know how someone would find this. You have to you had to go. I went to a coal mine, took a left at another coal mine.
The bird died.
Right.
And found the core. The core,
here's
the center
line.
Of the earth, and we were right there.
Will we ever be in the nationwide bestsellers? Probably not. But I don't care. I am looking underneath bestsellers in arts and literature biographies. And there we are at 22, and I
it
want to
looks
be
fabulous.
I want to be on the front page. I want to be
not
on
hard,
the.
That's not a long trip to make, Mike.
No.
I mean, we just need to have people try a little harder. And
I think we sell 10 books today. We could get onto the other page.
And Mike, just really take some comfort in the fact: how many years have you called me late at night and said, "Listen, Lee Marvin is beating us again"? Well, today we're beating Lee Marvin. So in your
right.
face, dead Lee Marvin.
May I make a quick announcement about the book itself?
Yes, go ahead.
I think
do.
That a lot of people have been just writing and asking questions if they get the Kindle version, if we get credit, if they buy just the hardcover or the paperback, they get credit. We get credit if you buy the Kindle version or the paperback, and if you buy the paperback, you can get a discounted Kindle version. We do not get credit if you do anything but buy the Kindle or the paperback.
Okay.
Bottom line.
Do you know what the discount is?
Wait, explain that to me again. You confused me right there.
So,
what was that?
This is the business side, and I know you love numbers, Mike. But
yes,
when
I do.
When people buy the book, they can either buy the paperback or they can buy the Kindle.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have Amazon Prime, you can either you can sometimes get a deal where you buy the paperback and the Kindle comes at a discounted price.
I see.
So you can buy both as well. The only way we get credit, and by that I mean it's a percentage because we're self-publishing through Amazon.
Okay.
Is if you buy the paperback or buy the Kindle or buy both. That's the only way we get credit. And by credit, I mean we get some shekels coming our way.
Okay.
Just want to clarify for everybody out there.
So what are they doing where we don't get credit?
I don't want to. Why would I even highlight that, Mike? That wouldn't even make sense.
Okay. I'm just,
yes.
You know, we have these business meetings on the show, so I don't even know. I don't know what he just said, but I back it up 1,000%.
Thank you.
Let me simplify it this way for
you. And incidentally, Maria Menounos, you know, get the hell off of my list.
Yeah.
Get off of my list, biatch.
Wow. Okay. Hostile.
No,
you know, Oscar.
Yeah. I think she's very sweet.
Yeah, very sweet.
We're a country built on commerce.
Yes.
And so if you don't go out and buy our book, really what you're saying is you're not an American.
Well, that's a stretch.
No, I mean, I'm just painting in
broad
strokes.
A lot of people
strokes.
Are immigrants. They're not American.
Well, you
hey,
know
guess what?
You can feel American.
Not everybody's like you.
Oh, yeah. Are you ready? Are you ready for bestsellers in entertainer biography?
Yeah.
Can't wait.
We are number 13.
Oh. Hey, who's ahead of us?
And we are number 16. Who's ahead of us?
Yeah.
That let me see. I'll take this.
What?
Maya Angelou.
And that's, like I said, you know
what? Maya Angelou and Tina Fey and Billy Crystal.
Haven't they had enough?
Yeah, and you know what?
And John Wayne.
Really? Oh, the new John Wayne book, yeah.
And Penny Marshall is number one.
Always?
But the thing is, here's the weird. Oscar, explain this to me.
Okay.
Maria Menounos and Mindy Kaling are all over this thing, and so is Tina Fey.
Yes.
There are they have multiple spots, not just one or two, like four and
could
five.
Could one be
what
an audiobook?
An audiobook could work as well.
Mm-hmm. And one could be the dirty version.
Oh, it's got it listed. It's got it listed. Okay.
Unabridged.
So, wait, I've got it right here. Hold on. What our paperback is at number 13.
Okay.
Mm.
Our Kindle edition is at number 16. Oh, and that means we've got to do an audiobook.
Yeah, we do.
Oh, but it's in the plans. Were you not here for the meetings?
Yeah, I was. I know.
Oh, my God.
You know what we can do, Mike? We can record the audiobook.
Shouldn't we have had that ready
studio.
To go when we?
Oh my God, we've had so many conversations about this.
Yeah,
I swear, you just if it's not you talking, you don't listen. Like I have no idea.
Thank you.
Well, we'll talk about it later. There's a grand plan with the timeline.
Oh, I know. Yeah. I was at those meetings. I remember exactly what we said. When are we going to record? When are we going to record the audio book? When are we going to record the audio book?
I can't
are we
talk doing about it now.
You
we
do it
can't
today?
Talk about it.
No.
Okay, that's a secret meeting. That's a secret meeting. I'm sorry. I'm doing the best I can. I'm excited. Come on. I'm excited.
Stay tuned for a future opportunity to buy the audio book.
All right. Now, am I making that mistake? I know what he's doing.
Oh,
I speak
God.
Rob. I know exactly what he's doing right there.
Oh,
right.
It's like doing business with a blind man.
Yeah.
The thing is.
They won't buy a book.
Who knows if
that's
this.
That's what I'm saying. Hello. The Braille version's coming out next week.
Right.
I'm already thinking we need to write another one.
I would rethink that.
I'm already stuck. What the hell are you talking
now
about?
Now, that's
you
really not a positive
just saying,
bit of
let's
energy.
Let's get through this one first.
I think we ought to. Here's
just
my idea.
It's your mania. It's the same way you have the mania about food. It's like, what's next? Give me another. I need another. Give me another bear crawl. Give me another croissant with the chocolate in it.
What was
I
that? A bear what? Hold it. A bear what?
A bear crawl.
No, it's a.
You know.
Damn it. You know what I mean.
Crawl. A bear crawl, Mike.
Would you like to hear a story of willpower?
Please.
Yes. Please.
Yesterday, and I will talk about this in a moment, but I was a little down, and I think you boys know I was a little down. What you didn't know was that I was going to get this MRI, and I dread it. I do dread it. I hate the fact that, you know, I'm getting older and all this stuff when I got down here, so I'm not feeling too – I'm feeling blue, and Carla, God lover, picks up on that, and we're at the Costco because, you know, we live in the fast lane.
Yes.
So we're at the Costco, and Carla says, you know what? You're really down, and you've been really good about eating the right things. You know what? Why don't you go get yourself something that you want for dinner tonight? Get yourself some dessert item that you want for dinner tonight.
Mm.
So I went into Costco. And
I know what
now,
I
Rob, you can
right
relate
away.
To this.
I know what I would have gone right to.
You're unleashed in a place where Everything in that warehouse store directs you towards fattening food.
Of course.
It totally does.
Absolutely.
And so I came back like 5 minutes later with an entire Tres Leches cake.
Oh, I know the cake.
With caramel on top and
yes,
chocolate.
Yes, absolutely. Cake. Yeah,
an
I know
entire
exactly
cake.
The cake you mean, and it's delicious.
And then we got through, and about three quarters of the way through the shop, I put the cake on another, just a rack that was sitting there. I said, forget it. I don't need this.
Wow.
Oh, I don't need this.
Finally.
And we left the store. And in exchange for that, she let me get a one of those strawberry berry sundaes that they have at Costco. Mm. And I only ate like two mouthfuls of that.
Okay,
but
okay.
What I did was
yeah.
I gave my son a little taste of that. And ladies and gentlemen, do you want to see a heroin addict being born?
Oh, God.
Oh,
yeah.
My God. First of all, we just gave him a taste. You're not supposed to give him that kind
yeah,
of berry
I was like,
at this stage.
I don't know. That's on the,
it's just
the
a
game
taste,
plan
but
right
he's eating
there.
He's eating a lot of people food, yeah. So we did this.
Oh,
and
why not?
I gave him one, and that's what it was going to be. And then it was just like,
yeah.
Give
was
me
that
more
his first
more, so.
Processed sugar?
It may have been. Well, he's probably had something to do with it.
Here's Mike.
That's all we eat.
Here's when he came into Costco. It was the Wonka
what
music.
We'll see.
Look at this. Oh, boy. I can get the special
Mike,
treat.
Mike, aren't you scared? Now, your wife will make sure that little baby's fit.
Oh,
little boy
you bet
fit.
Your ass.
Yeah,
That young man has got a diet that is so much better than mine.
That's
when
two
I was
different
a little
disciplines.
Kid. Yeah,
like you
absolutely.
Will raise him with one discipline, and she will continue with the other.
But to be fair, you know what? Carla, who is an amazing specimen, is also a fan of food.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, he's not going to be deprived. He's not going to live on, ice water and lettuce.
No, I understand. But there's no other joy than sharing something you love with your loved one.
Mm-hmm.
I know that feeling with my niece or nephew that I really love this. I want you to love it as well. Mm-hmm.
But
when
this moment, if there was ever any indicator, my God. I mean, he's responded positively to food before. And sweet. Certainly give him bananas. You give him stuff like that. But when I saw this reaction to the processed sugar, oh, my God. He was like, he wanted to come. He turned into a demon child.
You can't feed Gizmo after 9. You know that.
Yeah,
like you just can't do it.
That's what, gremlins?
Yes. Yeah.
Because Mike was just agreeing to be polite. I want you to know that.
I don't know what the F he was talking about.
I do think the first time we gave Julia ice cream, she didn't go demon, but I do believe she made a noise we'd never heard before. I think she just went, ah, ma, 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 ma.
Well, I don't want to get any fatter, and especially after getting my MRI yesterday, which is really not. You know what? I want to have a fun afternoon? Be a fat guy going to get an MRI. We'll take a break. I'll tell you all about that when we come back. And Horny Bob Spiewak gets a motorcycle.
Yes!
All that coming up on the Mike O'Mara Show.
Rusty Shack. All I had was hanging on my back. Only you know.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. You know, this podcast has no better friends than the good people at Encore Insurance Services. They are fantastic supporters of our show from way back, and they can help you out, too. If you're out there shopping insurance, you know how hard it is to know which company offers the best value. Encore Insurance can help. Encore surveys the most highly rated companies in the insurance industry to compare premiums. Encore does the work so you don't have to. It's free, there's no obligation, and no salesman will visit you. The second half of this commercial will be read in the style of Chris Core.
Oh, good.
Oscar Santana used Encore, and you should, too. Just call toll-free 1-866-347-5748 to get a free life insurance quote. Or visit smartterm.com. That's SMARTTRM.com. That's where you'll find the license disclaimer and quality customer service. Encore Insurance Services, LLC. Check them out. For us, but mostly do it for yourself. Stop paying too much for life insurance. Protect your family the smart way at smartterm.com.
Oh, hey, Chris.
Dead on.
Look at me
Hi,
for a
Rob.
Second. I can't tell if you're looking at me. Your eyes are going in different directions.
Take it from me, Chris Hoare. All right. Thank you. I don't know why he popped into my brain.
I love the fact that you live 800 miles from him and you're still thinking of him.
Yeah, well, that little trip up to D.C. and one in a couple of weeks and all set for another trip up to D.C. when we're coming up for the book signing. And then the whole gang is heading up to Maine. And I will tell you that I am going to have a blissful commute when I return to D.C. the next time. Very, very happy.
As you should.
I'm at the joint right down the street. Oscar.
Oh,
wow. Yes. Looking forward to that.
That week,
absolutely.
I'm sleeping at the Starbucks, Mike. They've got a couch, and I'll just be there.
Oh,
overnight.
We can have dinner and hang out. It'd be fun.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, as a matter of fact, Mrs. O'Mara, I think, will be taking the buggy since I'll be probably walking to work.
I'll be like your older brother. Yeah, you know what? We can meet, get some breakfast at the deli,
sure.
Have a pre-show meeting, and then head on down to the studio.
That's right.
Okay. Let's move on.
Hey, and then you can go to CrossFit.
Guess not.
And kill
you,
him.
I can get you a weekly pass to the gym.
That'd be nice. W-E-A-K?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are there any golf courses around where you live?
Oh, yeah, Mike. All the wide open space here in Washington, D.C.
Yeah, there really is.
Congressional is the closest one.
Yeah, and they'd love to have you.
You
all right, I'm going to go on record. Let me put it out there.
Oh, yeah, please.
Oh, no.
If you happen to be a listener to the Mike O'Mara Show, you got any hookups around Congressional?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you know what? If you have a hookup at Congressional and you can willing to give Mike a ride. Because he doesn't have a car. So just come and
you know
pick
what?
Him up and take
you know,
him to
Batman, I'm
going to
tell you something. I hope it happens now.
I do, too.
I hope it happens.
I do, too.
I just, the way it looks right now is that, you know, I'm going to be working, and we're a one-car family, and I think Mrs. O'Mara is probably going to be out visiting, hopping around, seeing the family back in Virginia, so I'll be in D.C., and I'm, you know, I'm going to have some time.
What about relay rides? You could rent someone's car for the week.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, remember that app? I'm actually using it in
Bangor,
Maine.
Oh, I'll do that. I'll do relay rides that week. If it's not too expensive, I'll do
no.
it. It's not expensive, is it?
Oh, I can go right now and let you know what they have to offer.
Pennies
okay,
a mile.
Today.
Pennies a mile.
I'd like to do that. So yesterday, I was in a bit of a funk all day long because I've had this issue with my old man hip. And the fact is, you know, being a skilled, gifted athlete for years has caused wear and tear on all of my joints, and especially my hip.
Yeah.
And so I went to the doctor, and finally, after the second visit, he said, you know, an x-ray is one thing, but I think it's time for an MRI. And I have been through this drill because if, you know, a lot of people don't even know this that listen to the show, but I have had major back surgery. I've had two major shoulder surgeries, and I guess a scoped knee is still a major knee surgery.
I've had two
knee surgeries, including an ACL replacement.
Which is the leg that's the corpse's leg?
Right. The ACL.
Yeah, and it's the entire leg was actually that of a corpse, and they replaced it on your body.
Above the knee, sewn on above the knee. If you want to see, as a matter of fact, exactly what the procedure is like, I would direct you towards a television show that's running currently entitled Penny Dreadful. That is, that's if you want to see exactly what my surgery was like.
Sure.
So getting this done again, and it was discovered by a chiropractor who said, you know, that's not a pulled groin muscle, you got a hip issue. And I'm going to send you to a guy that's going to check you out. And he confirmed it. And then I went to another guy, and he had a theory. And then I went back, and they finally gave me an MRI because it's been hurting, and got the call this morning. But I'll tell you the results because it's some interesting stuff that I might be doing. And the MRI process is, for men of larger carriage,
it's a tube.
Let me just say that I'm very fortunate that I still can get an MRI. And I don't think that, you know, the MRI is the equivalent of those certain roller coasters that they probably don't allow you to go on now.
Exactly,
Rob.
Mike. Well, a lot of times what I have to do is I have to, you know, a lot of times the sixth row in a roller coaster, I know this for a fact, the sixth row is caters to those of larger carriage. So
are you asking me?
I kid you
not.
Do
they have a special row for fat people?
On certain coasters, yeah.
Really?
I first found out about it on the Alpengeist at Busch Gardens. And they said, you're going to want to probably try row number 6. And it was wondrous. But when you go,
jam you in there.
Now, have you explored the notion of the open MRI? Because I know they do that. Where
you don't go
in the tube.
They just said you need an MRI. So let's
What's
the
first
and
available? Would it be more like taking a Tostito chip and trying to fit it into a Pringles can?
A little bit, yeah. A little bit.
Let's just say I do experience, one of the big questions they ask you when you're going to get this thing done is, do you have claustrophobia? And I do have a bit of claustrophobia in this. And I discovered it one of my MRIs about a couple of years ago when I was getting the knee done, where I was in there and the thing was going,
it's loud, very loud.
And suddenly I realized I'm in here. There's no real way of getting out of here.
I've got loose change in my pockets.
And I started to wig out. But, you know, it's funny because you do, your mind, you got a half an hour, you're on this rack in a tube, and all you can do really, there's a little music in the background, but all you can do is think. And one of the things I was thinking about, with the modern technology existing in our medical world now, the tiny little things they can do to make it easier that they choose not to do.
Such as?
So, well, for example, the best one I ever had, and they talk about an open MRI where they build an entire different machine
a room.
So that you're not enclosed. And I said, the best one I ever had, they gave me headphones and goggles and piped in a little television.
Ah.
And that's it. And so you hear the TV and you're in the guy. You're not even aware you're in that. Now, giving you that, they all, I think, give you headphones to listen to some music.
What did they? What music did they provide you with?
Oh God, it was a Bob Seger album, and I, you
what?
Know, I mad
did they
mad
know you
respect.
Worked at a classic rock station?
Hey, were you talking up the songs?
They asked me seriously. They asked me what I wanted, and I said light classical, out of the same movie Soylent Green,
yes.
When Edward G. Robin says classical, light classical, and they asked him what kind of music. Well, the bird that was giving me the MRI didn't know what light classical was.
The bird.
Duh. So, you know, and that fills me with tremendous amounts of confidence right there. Light classical. I said, it's classical music, but it's not heavy.
Right.
That's how I explained it to her. So they couldn't find that, and I said, just, you know, put on some classic rock. So they put an entire Bob Seger album on and then slid me in, and my the so it's like and they said, you're not going to have your head in the tube, so you really don't have to worry about claustrophobia. But what they didn't mention was my chin would be almost to where the tube starts. And because of the fact that with my wide shoulders, that it's like putting a 12 pounds of potatoes in an 8-pound sack.
Sure.
I had to hold my hands above my head for a half an hour.
Did they fall asleep?
And they didn't fall asleep, but about 5 minutes in, I said, isn't this the position that Jesus was in when they put him on? Didn't they actually devise a torture chamber type? The cross, the crucifixion was raising your arms up because it makes it harder to breathe, for Christ's sake. You're telling me to put my hands above my head for a half an hour.
You were playing America's New Game, Crucifact or Crucifixion, and it came up winner.
Right. So every periodically, like every 3 to 5 minutes, she comes on, and I'm in the thing going, you know, turn that up a little bit. And it's going.
I was 18. Okay, Mike. Didn't have a kid. The next one's going to be about 3 minutes. It's going to be about 3 minutes. Just keep motionless with your hands above your head. And I'm like, I was solid everywhere.
How you doing,
Mike?
I'm fine.
Okay, going to be about another 5 to 7 minutes right now. My steps were quick and loud. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, we're going to just do one more. This one's going to be about 7 more minutes, and then you're all done.
So, the next one.
How you doing? You okay? Keep your hands above your head. Stay motionless, please.
All right.
Okay, I think we're all done now.
Can you turn the music off, please?
How's that?
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. I forgot about that. Yeah, we'll turn that off now. Just a second. I'm having trouble finding where the button is, although I'm controlling this $10,000 piece of equipment. Maybe a $500,000 piece of equipment. Thank you.
Mike, you know what?
This is what happened. So okay. She says, Mr. O'Meara?
Yeah. Okay, we're just about done, but...
I'm going to be having to come out there. I think I want to take a couple of more pictures. I don't know what happened at the end, but the last two just didn't come out that right.
Does that mean you want me to put my hands over my head?
Sorry. Yeah, we're going to have you do that. So it'll be just another 7 to 10 minutes.
All right. So anyway, that's the way it went with my MR, and it was just
torturous.
That is
it was,
hell.
It ended up being really look, torturous is a too strong word, but I will tell you, it was definitely not a pleasant deal. And the main thing was that, you know, because I am a fat tub of goo, you know, I can't keep my shoulders at my side. I got to keep my hand. Well, I think even if you're thin for this particular hip MRI, they had to keep the hands out of the way down there. And, you know, I'm constantly playing with myself.
I know you are.
That was a real challenge.
You want to touch yourself all over.
Always.
All
constantly.
Over. And that is really, Mike,
constantly.
That's not because you lack self-control, but you're so in touch with your body.
Right. But you know what? It's going through this, you know, you always want to get checked out. And once again, salute to the insurance company for picking up one third of the cost.
Hey,
really want to say thank you.
Oh,
for
things
that.
Are really yes. working out, huh?
Yeah, they're all the same. They're all the
I
same.
I had that
basically.
Same. So I have basically, you know, I get like heartburn once in a while, but once in a while, it gets really bad. So
right.
I have to get different medication.
Yeah, you've had
the
bad
reflux.
Stomach
yeah,
problems
yeah, just,
forever.
It's horrible. And I went to the and I've had good experiences. My dentist is great. My dental coverage and my doctor visits the same as before. But some of these medications that I remember being, like, covered in the past, and mind you, not as good a coverage as far as doctor care is concerned, just medication care mm-hmm. is a little different. I sat there, and I was like, oh, this is kind of a high bill. What happened?
Yeah, what happened
they
here?
Don't cover
premium I'm playing.
And, case. You know, all that trouble you went through with that hole in your stomach, you thought it was an ulcer. I could have given you a diagnosis from day number one.
Yes.
Spicy food.
That's exactly what it is. My chick has some vegetarian, like burritos that are spicy. Just say a little spicy, right? Mm-hmm. And because she doesn't eat meat, she's going through this whole thing.
Sure.
So yeah. I actually enjoy them. I'm like, it's pretty good. But if I eat even one of them, not 5 minutes after I'm done.
Trigger?
No, not trigger. It's just the pain. Like somebody just took a bunch of cigars and is putting them out on my chest.
Have you gotten that fixed finally? Do you have medication?
I have medication. I take Nexium on a regular basis. I think that I probably have to go see a doctor sooner than later.
Stop calling your relatives and just go to the office. But
yeah.
He's right with the insurance and the way it's not taken care of. And all this procedure to go through to get an MRI so the doctor can call me this morning and say, it's the doctor's on. Mike, the doctor's on the phone. Hey, Doc, how you doing?
Hey, Mr. O'Mara, how are you? It's your hip. Have a nice day.
Anyway, so that's it. So
but
it's
you knew
a,
that
it's
going
hip.
In.
I sort of knew that. It was a confirmation, but I'm very, very excited about getting this thing fixed in a very unique way, but I'm not comfortable talking about it.
Understood.
Okay. I'd rather get things done.
They make it
with
titanium, you know that.
I'm not getting a hip replacement.
They used to be made of wood.
Really?
Yes, and they didn't last at all.
Redwood?
And termites would kill you.
Oh.
I'm not getting a hip replacement right now.
Oh,
that's
good.
It. But I will be. I'm so pumped about this that I will. Look forward to discussing it, and once I you know go through what I'm going to go through, I'll talk about it.
You don't want to jinx it, Mike.
That's exactly right. That's what I don't want to do.
You don't want to jinx it.
But it is you know for men of larger carriage, when you have to go in there, it is not not a pleasant thing.
If you
thing.
Do have to have surgery, which again,
I'm not getting surgery.
I hope that doesn't.
I'm just going to say that, so there's no
but
speculation. I'm not getting
happen,
surgery.
If that does happen, think of the marketing value of open mic.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
From corporate radio to new media, the story of the Mike O'Mara Show. My God, yeah. my God.
Yeah, because it'd be open mic the book and then open mic the surgery.
Yeah, and
that's
then
right.
open MRI the book
yeah.
and open
By
MRI
the, way,
the surgery.
Before we take a break here, I do want to mention to everybody we are going to be at Jimmy's Old Town Tavern, and we're going to be there on the night of June 26th.
26th.
Right about
it's
that?
Thursday 26th. The 26th. Yeah, it'll be all right.
Thursday, June 26th, we're going to be there from 6:30 till 8.
Exactly.
6:30 till 8. The entire crew will be out there signing copies of Open Mic. So get your paper back and bring it to Jimmy's, and we will sign it for you. No salutations.
No, I will include salutations. How about that?
Of course you will.
I will not
You'd
be
write
Al
a
Lewis.
Novel yourself. You'd write 5 pages.
Mike, I think it's time we think about writing
Dear
another novel.
Dear Rob Mobber, thanks for coming out and supporting the cause.
You know what, Oscar? I know you feel bad about it, but I'll work with you, and we'll help you figure out something
I
you know
don't
how to write.
A mob.
No, no, it's not the mob. I just want
the
you
writing?
To know how to write something.
Stay classy.
I'll be sitting next to Rob, and of course, I will be giving my standard salutation,
which is
best Mike. Thank you. Thank you very much.
And you know why he writes that, Oscar?
Why is that?
Because he is the best, Mike.
Oh, right back at you, pal. We'll take a break, come back with more news you may not need. Coming up next, this is the Mike Domeri Show.
It's the Rob and Joe Show, starring Rob Spiewak and Joe Robbins.
Why are you saying you're Rob Spiewak?
Well, because I think if people hear Rob and they think it's Rob Spiewak, they're more likely to listen.
We can't lie to the listeners.
I lie to people all the time.
All right, this is the Rob and Joe Show, starring Rob Spiewak and Joe Pesci.
Joe Biden.
Joe Montana.
Montana?
Theismann.
Spiewak and Theismann. I listen to that show. Rob and Joe Show, live on Monday nights and on robandjoeshow.com, iTunes, and Stitcher. Give us a listen.
I like that.
Definitely want to make sure we get Rob and Joe into our own studio to do the recording next time.
Yeah, I got it. You know, I'll text them right now, Mike. I'll text them right now.
Their engineer is one of their brothers. Welcome so I think that's nice.
To the Mike O'Mara Show. This segment of the Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by Stamps.com. Summertime and the living is easy. Yes, summer is finally here, and you want as much free time as possible. Am I right? Don't let going to the post office cut into that time. Use Stamps.com instead. Everybody knows that going to the post office is a drag. Finding the time, finding the parking, waiting in line, it sucks. Stamps.com is the better way. Buy and print official U.S. postage for any letter or package using your computer and printer, then just hand it to your mailman. It's that easy. Postage on demand. The future is now. We use Stamps.com, and we love it. It saves time, money, and our sanity. Act now for a 30-day free, no-risk trial and a $110 bonus offer that includes a free digital scale and up to $55 in free postage. Who doesn't want that?
Yeah.
Just go to Stamps.com and click on the microphone and use our code TMOS. Don't wait. Go to Stamps.com, and before you do anything else, click on the microphone at the top of the homepage and type in TMOS. Just remember, Stamps.com and TMOS. And I really did want to mention one last thing here regarding Stamps.com. They are a very, very, very loyal advertiser
of
the Mike O'Mara Show. And this is a significant advertiser for all of us, and we'd really, really love you to check out Stamps.com and experience their free trial. If you do that for us and you know somebody that does a lot of work with postage, even if you're somebody that sends out a tremendous amount of correspondence, help them out and you help the Mike O'Mara Show out at the same time. We really want to give a little boost. We do that for advertisers periodically, give them a little leg up because we talk about them all the time. They're very loyal to us, and we'd like you to be very loyal to them at Stamps.com. So please, if you know anybody that uses a lot of postage, that does a lot of mailing for their business, does a lot of mailing in general, please recommend Stamps.com and go to Mike O'Mara's show to link up to that.
Yeah,
we would appreciate that in advance.
Again, you can just also give them the code, send them a nice email, and say use TMOS.
Please.
Work out.
Yep.
Amen. We appreciate that. Welcome back to the show. Without further ado, let's get to the news you may not need.
From around the globe, across the nation, and looking through your neighbor's window, the Mike O'Mara Show now presents News You May Not Need, a comprehensive look at the stories you may or may not be talking about during your daily activity. And now, News You May Not Need.
A truck driver's lack of sleep is being blamed for the highway crash that injured Tracy Morgan and killed another comedian in New Jersey. As Morgan recovered in a hospital, authorities said Monday that the truck driver who triggered the weekend crash hadn't slept for more than 24 hours before the accident. We talked about it a little bit yesterday about regulating these truckers that are out there. Walmart trucker Kevin Roper is expected to appear in state court on Wednesday. It was unclear if Roper of Jonesboro, Georgia, had retained an attorney. He remained free after posting a $50,000 bond. Authorities said Roper apparently failed to slow for traffic ahead early Saturday in Cranberry Township and then swerved to avoid the crash. Instead, they said his big rig smashed into the back of Morgan's chauffeured limo bus, killing comedian James Jimmy Mac McNair and injuring Morgan and three other people. And I think they're saying now they're not going to have to remove Tracy Morgan's leg, that he's going to be able to
that's the latest
leg.
Update, yes.
So that's the very latest on that. A judge ruled Monday that Casey Kasem should be fed, hydrated, and medicated while a court-appointed attorney evaluates the health of the ailing radio personality after his daughter moved to implement end-of-life measures. Now, this is strange to me because you don't know the details.
This is the daughter that recently gained control.
Yes.
And she's starting the end-of-life procedures.
So Kasem has dementia. He was in critical condition in a Washington State hospital. His daughter, Carrie Kasem, who has been placed in temporary control of his treatment, consulted with doctors. Okay, that's the important part. And decided in recent days to stop giving her father food, water, and medications, attorney said in court. But I've read other things that say he is still aware. You know, it's a tough situation.
Do you know,
I don't
have you read anywhere if he's issued a DNR or if he had specified in advance how he wanted to go out?
I don't know, but this is very, very sad.
This is no way for anybody to go.
Yeah, when a family has to go through this. So, you know, for I'm going to look on the bright side here and think that the family is doing the humane thing and the right thing. But now a judge is involved, and it's got to be just painful for everybody concerned, especially Casey Kasem.
It's so tough. And, you know, I remember when Big Daddy was at the very end, what we determined, and we had to really leave it in the hands of the professionals. We said, do your best to keep him comfortable. But we don't want to prolong this because, in essence, he was gone.
Yes.
You know, it's a tough decision.
Very, very tough. As Michael Jackson's estate grows in value, the yearly allowance his children, Prince, Paris, and Blanket, they're 17, 16, and 12, the amount that they share has increased from $5 million to $8 million. And it sounds like they take full advantage of it. Page 6 talked to sources, including former Jackson friend Mark Schaffel, who's now engaged to Jackson's ex-wife Debbie Rowe, for details on how the kids spend their money. I thought it was worth going into this.
And you know what? You just glossed over the fact that his friend is now engaged to that ex-wife of the sham marriage. And he's got a kid named Blanket. There's nothing weird here.
No, nothing at all.
It's fine.
Prince has spent more than $50,000 on custom-made jewelry for three of his girlfriends, plus $40,000 on a new Ford pickup truck. He wants to save enough money to buy back his father's Neverland Ranch, currently in control of creditors, with an asking price of $35 million. Paris also likes to buy gifts for friends, including shoes and athletic gear. The annual cost for her to stay at a therapeutic boarding school following last year's suicide attempt is also in the six figures.
Wow.
Blanket likes to take his cousins to dinners at expensive restaurants. Their nights out, which also include trips to the movies, typically come to about $500 plus tips. He also spends $200 an hour for karate lessons and a personal trainer. Millionaire kids. You know
what I bet happens a lot, though? Hi, Blanket. It's Uncle Tito. How'd you like to take me out to dinner?
Let me see. How old is Blanket?
Did you say 11?
Blanket is 12.
12.
All right. Let me see. The kids also take three vacations a year, totaling $350,000.
Oh, where do they go? The moon?
Well, it isn't all inclusive.
That includes first class airfare and security in Hawaii. They stay in a $5,500 per night suite in Vegas. Why are they in Vegas?
Well, that's one of their father's favorite places.
Yeah, and that's where the karate instructor lives.
In Vegas, they sometimes rent the Bellagio's penthouse suite, which can cost as much as $5,000 per night.
So
that's what the Jackson kids are doing, if you were curious about
Intense.
That. Mm-hmm. A two-meter segment of the iconic, Rob, you're the Frenchman here.
Yes.
Is it Pont des Arts? Pont des Arts Bridge? Pont des Arts.
Pont d'Art. D'Art.
What?
D'Art.
Pont d'Art. P-O-N-T-D-E-S-A-R-T-S.
Pont d'Art.
Point de merci bleu bleu.
Bleu 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 bleu.
Well, that's the one where they put all the locks on the bridge.
I have a wonderful photograph of that bridge.
Wow. Were you on that bridge?
No. I won it at a sham art auction.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, it fell down.
Oh, no. Looks like the value of my photograph went up.
It's skyrocketing. It's the 20.
One person's tragedy. A two-meter segment of the bridge collapsed on Sunday night. The bridge has become famous for the love locks, a tradition in which people fasten a lock to the bridge and then throw the key into the river as a symbol of internal love and ironclad commitment. But the locks became too heavy, and a portion of the bridge buckled. A portion of the bridge railing buckled under the pressure of so many romantic expectations. a part of the bridge collapsed last summer under the weight of the locks, causing many to say the locks pose a safety threat to the thousands of people who walk over the bridge every day or ride under it on ferries. Oh, my God, a chunk of bridge will fall onto the ferry, killing people. No, mon ami.
You crazy young people are destroying the bridge at Point Noir.
Looks beautiful.
Yeah, bonjour. Gorgeous.
Hello.
I am here to issue a warning to each and every you. Any one of you that have been to the bridge with your lock, if they tear the bridge down, you will instantly break up and fall out of love.
Have you bought a lock lately? Like a real combination lock?
Like from Master?
Not a combination. I bought funky little locks for trailers.
So they have new combination locks. I got one for the gym. And they don't have the number locks anymore. Well, they do have them, but they don't really sell them. They sell now symbol locks where you have a triangle, a square, a rectangle. So you have to remember the different variations of your shapes before you get there.
Did you buy this at a Mensa store?
No. I bought it at CVS across the street.
Yeah. What it is, Mike, that's an international lock. It applies to everybody.
He lives in D.C., but he went over to Virginia to get it at that lock store. The new one that just opened up, Gavin's. Anyway, I'm sorry. It's terrible. I'm sorry, Tom. Tom, I love you. Insure.com just released the results of their annual report on the value of all the stuff dads do around the house, and they found that in 2014, the average dad, hello, Rob.
Yes, and you, hello, Mike.
Thank you. The average dad does $24,103 worth of work.
Really? Whoa. As a father?
That's a second job.
That is.
That's based on his work as an accountant, plumber, tutor, coach, handyman, car mechanic, builder, pest control worker, taxi driver, laborer, cook, and groundskeeper, and what you'd have to pay all of those people to do what dad does for free.
You left out something huge in that list.
What's that?
Entertainer.
Entertainer. Let's get for another 5K easy.
Yeah, sure.
Easy.
Plus tips.
The value's up 3% from last year and up 19% from 2012 S&E.
Well done.
We assume you're a coward and haven't taken a real punch to the face since you were a little kid. If ever. Well, if that day ever comes, just know that evolution has your back. A new study out of the University of Utah found that men's faces have evolved so they can take a punch.
Ooh, crumple zones.
That's so nice.
Our primitive crumple zones. Our primitive ancestors had faces that were flatter and way more fragile, but natural selection favored guys whose facial structure acted more like armor against a few punches, so the bone structure evolved. The researchers say the change started as men became more competitive over two things.
What's that?
You wonder what they are?
Yeah. Oh, I got it.
Okay.
Women and food.
Yes, sir. Way to go.
Hey, oh, I compete every day on that level.
Yeah, because everybody wants something to eat.
And now a little something, something. There's something about being drunk that makes people crave fast food, but sometimes it's better to stay home and make 5 Hot Pockets, and this was one of those times.
Oh, I love
Saturday night, 3 high school students driving around Arcadia, California. They see their social studies teachers standing on the sidewalk.
Yeah.
34-year-old John Maust. They stop him to say hi, but realize pretty quickly that he's hammered. Then they ask for a ride. He asks for a ride. But once he's in the car, he starts spouting a bunch of drunk nonsense. And whatever he said made them so nervous, they pulled over and got out.
But they left him in the car?
They're scared of their teacher.
Scared of the drunk teacher.
Well, they should have been. When they got out of the car, that's when John pulled the knife.
Oh, no.
He ordered them to take him to get fast food. Specifically, Jack in the Box. While they were on their way there, one of the students called 911. Then John heard a police helicopter overhead, made them stop the car, and took off on foot. He showed up at a police station the next day to turn himself in. He's charged with kidnapping. Wow. How drunk do you get?
Pretty drunk.
False imprisonment and making criminal threats. As of yesterday, he was still behind bars. His bail was set at $100,000. So the teacher was bogus for pulling the knife, and the students called 911, which means they were bogus, too.
Ah.
There we go. Safe travels to that guy. We'll take a break. Come back with the Magic Audio Vault and Rob Spiewak. You, ladies and gentlemen, are listening to the Mike O'Berry Show, and this is Elton John. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. You know, I used to think you needed a small fortune to effectively market your business. Not so, my friend.
That's right, my friend.
because Vistaprint.com has everything you need to get the word out about your products and services at prices that you will love. For a limited time only, just for our listeners, 250 high-quality premium cards for just $10, shipping included. So it's okay if you don't have a large marketing budget to spend on cards. Vistaprint allows you to order their quality cards at low everyday prices. In fact, they have a low price guarantee for their premium business cards. So if you're not happy, they're not happy. You can call them up and they will make it right. If you can manage it, if you can imagine it.
Yes. Mm.
I misspoke.
No, no.
If you can imagine it, Vistaprint can make it happen, people. Don't delay. Order your 250 high-quality premium business cards for just $10, shipping included. Just go to Vistaprint.com and put our promo code TMOS in the cart when you check out to get this offer. We've all designed cards. Everyone in this room has cards from Vistaprint because they are the best. 250 cards, $10, Vistaprint.com. Check them out and do it now. Without further ado, let's open up the audio vault for today, Tuesday, June 10, 2014. Rob Spiewak.
A couple of items for Father's Day as we gear up for the holiday where the family pretends to care.
Yes.
First off, Mike, do you remember in Breaking Bad, Walt Jr.? His son.
Absolutely.
There's a spoiler alert. If you've not caught up on all your reruns of Breaking Bad, there's some spoilers here. But he did post, Walt Jr. posted a Father's Day message that I found rather heartwarming.
A lot of fathers say they would do anything to provide for their family. But you, Walter White, really meant anything. Be it cook meth, poison a child, or choke a man named Crazy 8 with a bike lock. You always made sure that your family had an A1 day. You sacrificed so much to make sure your family always had what was most important, breakfast. Everything you did was for your children, and also your pride, and a ton of money, but definitely for your children too.
Love that. And
that's
also
funny.
For Father's Day, I think this was last Friday night, and it's on the Channel 5 website. Tony Perkins, a fellow Moore Broadcasting employee, brought his son Connor in to watch him do the news. And at the very end, as they were about to do the throw to the 11 o'clock, he brought Connor on camera. I thought it was a great moment.
This is my young man, Connor. Thanks for coming by the show tonight. Was it a good show?
Great show.
Thank you very much. Appreciate
that.
Yeah, we Sean asked him to grade our performances, 1 out of 10, 10 being the best, and you gave me what?
8.
What'd you give me?
8.
Excuse me, what was mine?
You weren't on that much, so I'll say 7.
All right. I'll take a 7.
All right, thank you, son. We're going.
Thank you for watching Fox 5. See you.
He signed them all.
Wow. I'm on my way out. The news keeps coming. The Edge at 11 begins right now.
Isn't that great?
Oh, good for you, Tony. That's fantastic.
And he was
what
so charismatic
moment.
On camera.
Yeah. Oh, was
so
he really?
Great. Yeah,
oh, that's fantastic. Fantastic.
Love
good stuff.
That. Love, love, love it. Now, are you familiar with the website Tinder?
I've heard of it.
Well,
yes.
it's really an app.
Well, whatever it is.
No, well, it's important. It's an app.
Okay. Are you
the
familiar
website.
With? Are you familiar with the app called Tinder?
No.
It's where a douchebag
see
can try to find a date. These are actual quotes that people typed out on Tinder to try to get laid. They sound so creepy, especially when you add music and dramatic readings. Remember, these are not written to be funny. These are actual proposals from Tinder.
Hey, I'm new to the area. Can I have directions to your apartment?
You're beautiful, by the way. We should share a bottle of wine, and then I would orally pleasure you all night.
You like dragons?
Who doesn't?
Good, because I'll be dragging these across your face tonight.
As long as I have a face, you have somewhere to sit.
Oh, God.
By the way, I go to Harvard.
Things seem to be moving fast here, so before we continue, I'm legally obligated to tell you I am a registered sex offender, but I'm not obligated to tell you why, so don't even think about asking. You like gelato?
Your name is my mom's name, but I'd still cover you in green paint and spank you like a disobedient avocado.
I put the STD in stud.
I'd love to treat you like a snowstorm.
And how does one treat a snowstorm?
Give you 6 to 8 inches and make it mildly inconvenient to move around in the morning.
No thanks.
God. So learn from these, Mike.
Wow.
You don't
and they're real?
Those are all real.
Yeah, I've seen a few. Pretty bad. I don't know if this is really going to work out. Though, a coffee table book would be great.
Yeah, I agree. Wow. Especially, you know what I think the problem is a lot of those people that were speaking ineffectively, they didn't realize it was an app. It's sure. not a website. It's an app.
It is.
So once you've cleared that up, it's fine. And we close. Mike, as we know, everyone wants to know, is Hillary going to run for president?
Do we think Hillary Clinton will run for president? Hillary said, she's given away a little hint. She said that her staff is now doing some internal polling. And I thought, oh, my God, no. So what got her husband in trouble? Come on. No.
That's your Magic Audio Vault. Have a great Tuesday, everybody.
All listener mail that we read on Thursday can be sent to ponyboy@mikeomaraShow.com. If you want to be part of our mailbag that we do every single Thursday at the beginning of the show, send it to ponyboy@mikeomaraShow.com. And the book is out right now, Open Mic, from corporate radio to new media, the story of the Mike O'Mara Show. You can get it by going to our page, mikeomaraShow.com, and clicking on the link that says Open Mic. Give us a nice review on there at Amazon. We'd appreciate that. We'll be back with another brand new show tomorrow. So long, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
Wait, don't go. I need to tell you that MikeOmeraShow.com/Amazon is perfect for all your online shopping needs. Shop the best way. Shop Amazon. And please go through our website, always open at MikeOmeraShow.com/Amazon.
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.